Hello, friends. My name is John Stewart, and I'd like to welcome you to Extra Credit with Ricky Quinn. On this episode, we are going to continue the conversation with Ricky as he works a three-year-old gelding named Yaya. If you missed our first episode, I suggest you stop now and go watch the first episode and catch up. So, Ricky, welcome. Let's continue this conversation about you and Yaya.
Okay.
All right. Let me pull up the video. So in the first episode, we watched you do groundwork. We talked through a lot of the groundwork on this young horse. And Yaya, as you mentioned, is a three-year-old or coming three-year-old that was started at Brannaman's Clinic last year as a two-year-old. And you really started working with them in November. And the video that we're going to show is from January out at one of your clinics in Cave Creek, Arizona. If I remember correctly, Yaya's breeding, CD Lights on the top side, and Murata. This horse is bred to be a pretty athletic cow horse, correct?
Yeah, that's one of the reasons I picked him. I know Wes, who started him, was kind of high on him, and he started very, very easy, not a lot of trouble, you know, and that's why I took him.
That's great.
No trouble. Well, yeah.
I know you breed some incredible horses out there at Lazy U, and we're going to go ahead and pull up a video of you getting in the saddle with Yaya. So here we go. So Ricky, why don't you give us the play-by-play and tell us what's going on? Obviously, you just hopped in the saddle on Yaya.
Yeah. So I'm just going to try to do a repeat of what I was doing on the ground, John. And so you'll see a lot of similarities. And if I was standing on the ground, I'm just trying to draw the nose and roll the hind. I'll go the other way. If I'm standing on the left side of the horse, just trying to draw the nose, roll my left leg back and roll the hind. I'm really focusing on not just the inside hind leg, but the outside hind leg. And at times when I'm doing this, you'll kind of see him speed up a little bit here. I remember watching this video and seeing it right there. Mm-hmm. I'm just saying, hey, get those hind feet over there. But what's really important is to notice that he's not going sideways while I'm doing this. When I pick up on the rein, the shoulders aren't going, you know, right there he is. I don't want that. So I stay there. I got the hind to catch up. And so that is something that is really a big deal. If I have a horse that's really leaning to the inside, then maybe you would allow that a little bit. But you have to be kind of careful. That drifting sideways, it bothers them. They get way out of balance. And so if that shoulder is pointed left and running left and the hindquarters isn't catching up, you might think that you have bend in your horse, and because he's crossing the inside hind leg over, that you're getting to the hindquarters, but you're actually not. He needs to be powerful, moving straight forward and through. Sorry, John, what was that?
No, I was just saying you can see how really getting power from the back is what you're trying to accomplish here.
And watch, John, as I do that, as I do this, it'll happen more than once. I roll the hind, and then that front will reach slightly to the inside. So you hear he's struggling a little, so yeah. I stay with it until that right front reaches right in here. See how he's drifting outside, and I'm saying, come on, get that right front, stay forward.
Cat stalls out there.
Whoop, decided to work on the hind, I guess, or the front. Can you rewind it a little, John?
Absolutely, I can.
Since I've started in on the front end. He's doing good with the hind. So watch here, the left front. The left front is actually reaching to the inside. It will, when it's correct, slightly.
There.
See him just kind of line out and get flat? That's really important. And as I come through here, that right front will start to reach to the inside. See, he's drifting to the outside. Well, you got to rewind it more, John. We need more. Keep rewinding. Rewind a ways if you can. There, give us a few chances to see it here. So again, as I drift, watch that right front, that white foot. See, he's outside, and the hind, there it goes. See it? His whole body lines out, and that's really important when you're working it. The bending of a horse isn't necessarily, we got to be careful not to get stuck on the bend itself. It's about what is the spine doing? What are those feet doing? Right? And you can overbend one to where he becomes disconnected from his feet. I know, I've done this. And so I'm, you know, if he doesn't know how to bend, then I'm going to help him learn how to bend. But as soon as he starts, there's that right front. Yeah.
See, and that's, I'm going to rewind this again, Ricky, because this is exactly why we're doing this. When I'm watching you do this live, I'm missing so much of this. Because it's still going out there.
Right there at the end. And see, I released for that, John, before it happened. I don't know if you noticed that. If you want to rewind it again.
Yeah.
Right?
Oops. It went a little bit further.
There's a lot of times where I can feel the body shaping up and the foot's going to go, and so I release, and then the foot goes. It's same thing in the hindquarters front end on the ground when we roll here the hind. Get ready here. Right there, release. See, and then it happens. Yeah. You'll start to feel them shape up, and then it just, when it's right, and it works.
You get out of the way and let them go. Into it. Yep.
Yeah, it'll probably happen here again. Right there. See it?
Yeah.
It happened 2 times in a row. That's kind of cool. See that right front again? There. See him really reaching that front? But he's not stopping the hind to reach the front. He's staying, I'm wanting him to stay very engaged and forward. As he finds this, he's a little lost here. He's drifting to the outside. There he found it. He lined out, got flat. Had to speed him up there. I'm waiting for him to really find that left front and stay forward and through this. There it is, right there.
Right there.
Yeah.
It's fascinating to watch this with you to where now I'm just watching when you're giving the release.
Yeah. Now I think we'll start working on the front. Right. So I'll wait for him to kind of find his feet. I'll kind of lift on that rein, and I'm encouraging him to really watch the left hind here. I got to wait for him to set up. Now, when it right here, I change my hand, watch his left hind, and that's what I release for. Got it. Right. So now I got the hind quarters rolling the hind the way I need it. Now I'm going to start working on the front. And it's going to be the same as in the groundwork, that I need to place those hind quarters before I really start trying to get that front to come through. So there's the hind, right? And then watch my left hand. That's what'll tell you what right here, right there. Now I'm asking for the front. He's stuck. He's just stuck. So I'll wait. I might lift on the rein a little bit, but I'm not going to kick and hurry this. Let him think his way through it and watch the right hind. Right there, I release. So I'm not releasing for the front right now. His hind was in the way. And so I've got to get that hind out of the way. So here's my hind quarters. Now I'm going to ask him to bring the front. Now watch here. He's stuck again. He's balled up. That's why all the bend and the head is flat and all that stuff. I'll just lift here nice and easy. I'm not tugging hard. Just trying to create life release for the left hind. I'll go at it again and say, can you get your that? There it is. And then I release. He's shaping it up through his body there.
And look at him breathe.
Yeah, it's really a relaxing thing, you know. What happens is what I have done in the past is when I go to, here's the hind and I want the front, I get a little bit too anxious in here as if I have to have the front right now. Instead of sitting right here and letting them work their way through this, see, I need that hind.
Yeah.
I need that hind to clear to the right and back. This is where backing circles will come in really handy in the future to refine this even more. But I'm just using one rein. And some people, you know, I know that I've talked to a lot of people about, you know, everybody's theories on this stuff. And some people would watch this and go, what the heck are you doing? Pick up on your outside rein, right? And you can. But there's one thing that my horses will have, especially when it comes time to work a cow, is that I don't have to do a whole lot with my reins to get my horse's front feet over there. Right. I can draw on that rein a certain way, and he'll set his hind feet and go. There's not much manipulation because I go about this pretty slow, and I let this horse find this place. See, that hind is in the way. Mm-hmm. He's got to reposition his hind, right? And he's awkward right now. His head's on upside down. He's working his mouth. His eyes are rolled back. And see the shift of weight I'm releasing for? Watch for the shift of weight. That's what I'll release for right. There's the hind. And there's almost. And there's the front.
There you go.
right? So it can, for a lot of people, they don't want their horse bent like that. But as long as you're patient and you wait for them to think their way through that, you just watch how this will develop in this little horse, because he's pretty stuck there in that front end. He's really green here. He doesn't look like this today. So he's stuck again. He doesn't know how to make the transition from the front to, or from the hind to the front. Sorry, John, I cut you off again.
No. I was just, I think one of the most important things here is just watching you and realizing how patient you are with this horse. I mean, it's, he's such a baby, but just letting him figure that out.
Well, I'm letting him think. You know, I know that I can, I'm wearing spurs on my feet, and I know how heavy I can be with my hands, right? I know I can get him over there. But that's not the point. At this point in my horsemanship career, it's not, I don't question whether I can get him over there anymore. What I'm working on is, how does he get himself over there? That's kind of the thoughts that I have going through my mind when I'm working them now. That's just a human being evolving, you know?
So same and thing then, here. And, what are you working
and
on?
And really be watching the release here, the shift of weight when I release. Mm-hmm. A lot of times it's not just the step that he takes. That there's one time here, I think it, can't remember where it is in the video exactly. We'll stumble onto it here, but there's a place here where I release for a shift of weight three different times before he ever takes a step. Mm. And that's him trying, him shifting his weight and trying to do the maneuver. And I release for it to say yes and encourage that, right? So right here, he's stuck. Release. I'll ask again because it's not quite right. Get that right hind and the body over there. Situate yourself. And I'm just lifting, not torquing on him, not there's the hind.
There.
There's the hind. There's my right hind. There's, now I'm just staying a little bit to see if he can, there, put the front end in with it, right? So he got to where that hind was repositioning itself. Then I was working on incorporating the front end with that repositioning of the hind. So here I roll the hind because that helps prepare. And then at some point I will change the position of my hand right there. There's my hind. There is my front. There you go, John.
That's what it's supposed to look like.
Yeah. And it was very stuck and awkward looking before that. Well, that's how this works. It doesn't all just magically happen, you know? So there's my hind, and he may get stuck this time. Doesn't mean that from now, from here on out, the rest of our lives, that it's going to be, you know, like the last one was. There's going to be a lot of times he has hinds in the way. He's got to get the right hind out of the way. Get your right hind over there. He says, I say, you got to get your right hind over. That's what causes you to get back and to draw on the cow. Ooh, almost. But it felt good, so I let him have it. Right? Yeah. And every once in a while, I'll kind of speed him up here and say, get some life in those feet. So there's our hind quarter work again. There's the hind, and there's your front. I'll go the other way, apparently. And this little horse, too, you know, Sarah has said several times, she said, that horse has a hard time. He's like a little football with legs. And, he's a pretty muscly little guy, and there's a lot of growing going on. So I'm also trying to be very sensitive of that,
yeah.
Whether it's soreness or tightness or just growth. Do you see the front there, John?
I'm going to rewind that just real quick because I think that's really nice to watch.
Yeah, that was a nice – it was a flow. See, it was a flow from the hind. Now I just – while I'm rolling the hind, I say, where's the front? And he just puts it together and makes it happen. I didn't wait for the hind to stop. So here's the hind, and I just open up and just say, you figure it out. And he says, here, I can do it, no problem. So I just roll the hind, and then just randomly I'm going to say, all right, the cow's going to the right. What are you going to do about it? What are you going to do about it? What are you going to do? And he says, I'm going to kind of stumble over here a little. But he'll start to put all that together to where I can just go a straight line, open up, and he'll just shut his hind feet down and come through with the front end.
We can hear your own colt in the background.
Yeah.
That's nice.
Yeah. Hopefully that's not too annoying.
Oh, no. We love the fact that you're working a cult in your own house.
There you go. Yeah, so
now he's you're just getting them to move out a little bit.
Yeah, yeah. And all those people are standing over there because you're videoing. Usually I'd have them working right now. They're being kind enough to let you and I do this. There's the hind. And now I'm just trying to get the hind. Now I'm just saying, find your feet. There you go. Good job. And then go. Right? So putting it all together. And so now I'm asking for the hind quarters. Draw down. There's my hind. And then I'm going to open up. Is it all right? The cow's getting ready to go to the left. You ready? Yeah, yeah. And then once we make our turn, I'll send him as if we made our turn and we got to go. Good job. Yep, that horse is really kind of starting to get his feet figured out and put those things together. Now, take note of his head position and how he'll kind of get soft with two reins. Mm-hmm. He's drifting to the outside of the circle quite a bit, but that's okay. That's a green horse thing. But you'll find that he'll get really soft through his jaw and through his pole here at times. Not because I've ridden him much with two hands, because I haven't. Most of his work has been this kind of thing. Mm-hmm. I haven't like rode around working on soft feels. I get a lot of that break in the jaw and the pole by doing what I'm doing right now. Rolling the hind and bringing the front will really start to get that jaw and that head and neck really loosened up for the future of me pit right there. That's because of my one rein work. That is not because of me riding around with two hands. That's all my one rein that causes that kind of a frame in my horses today. I used to do a lot of two rein work to get it done, but this right here is what's causing it for me now, but not having them over bent, right? That's in a way that was a little bit more bend than what I want right now, but he's kind of lost in his feet. And so I got to slow him down. In time, I'd like to just be able to kind of tip his eye and roll those hindquarters over and bring that front through. The straighter I can get him, the better for his education. So I'm working at utilizing my bend to get through to those there. That's really good right there. Now I'm working two hands in there. Yeah. I'm saying, hey, this outside rein, can I slow your keep your shoulder from drifting to the outside of this outside rein? And he said, yeah, I'll work at that a little bit, right? And he says, I'm struggling there a little. Yeah, good job.
I'm going to rewind that real quick just to see that again, Ricky, because
there might be more too. Yeah. See, his shoulders are going left. See that?
Yep.
They're going away, and I'm wanting the hind. And he's saying, I don't know how to do this with two hands. And I'm saying, well, now I can kind of use my, there it is. There he's coming through. And right here he gets lost, and I come in with my outside leg a little there and say, come on. And he just follows right through without any trouble. And that's because of the patience and the waiting early with one rein.
So, cool.
Yeah. And today this horse doesn't even... not even close to what this is.
Cool little horse. I can't wait to show another video of this horse after a couple of months of doing this.
See that front end? Rewind that again, John.
I will.
If you can.
We'll get there.
Will. Okay. Yeah, we'll come on around again.
Here we go.
But watch coming to the left, how nicely this horse rounds up with two hands here. Video kind of went bad on. Kind of rounds out really, as I come through here, he rounds out really good, and he gets him shoulders over there.
Right there.
Watch here. He'll just kind of get his, let's see, right there. That's how I want my horse to travel. Yep. Engaged, engaged, engaged. Right here. Watch that front end get over. Watch here. Right there. See it?
Yeah.
And then I move the shoulders over. Get that front end over to the left, right there. See him start to get nice and flat. Now I'm leg yielding. Now I'll bring the front to the right with two hands. Right there, he stays very engaged and flat and forward. There's my ride.
Man,
and for a horse of that age, you really don't need to do anymore until he can kind of wake up in the morning, he and I together, and start the day just like that. I really shouldn't be moving on too much more than that, really.
Well, that's a good ride.
Yeah, it's a good ride.
I mean, to see the progression of that, and So this was in January. We're going to continue on, and we'll shoot some more video of where you are with this horse now, and for future episodes. But I think that's a great place to kind of stop. And I invite people, if you're watching this, feel free to send us your comments, comment on the video, send us a message through through one of Ricky's Facebook pages or the YouTube channel, or even through RickyQuinnClinics.com. We're doing this video so that if you want to go deeper and ask questions, this is a great format to do that. So, Ricky, our next video that we're going to do will be with another horse that you're working. We'll do the same thing with another horse so we can see how you're working Steve, this other horse. You want to tell us about the next horse we're going to show people?
Yeah, he started as a three-year-old, not a two-year-old. Started as three this last June. We call him Steve, so he's coming four. He's late born. He'd come four in like June or July. And he'll have half a year on him, something like that. He's a don't look back on the top and a Krogman's on the bottom. And he'll be both of these horses. I'm hoping that I can show them a little bit. That's what I'm preparing them for. They're the kind. And Steve is just a completely different type of horse. And if you're in how, when I do groundwork, how he handles groundwork and mentally what he does, if there's going to be some resistance. And he's not quite as natural about bringing the front end through the way Yeah is, because the Yeah's physical makeup, it's a little easier for him. And so Steve will struggle with it just in different ways, and being able to discuss that and talk about that and people to be able to compare it. Because when you mess with these horses, you know, you can do groundwork with all of them, and all these horses are different for different reasons, whether it be a mental or a physical or who knows what, right? It can be a little bit different. And so the groundwork and then riding him.
Well, good. Well, Ricky, thank you for this time. I look forward to the next episode and meeting Steve and letting everybody else kind of follow along on this journey. So we'll bring it to a close on this episode. If you want to follow Ricky Quinn, you can follow him on social media, Facebook, YouTube. His schedule is always available at RickyQuinnClinics.com. And until next time, I'm John Stewart. Thanks for joining us for Extra Credit with Ricky Quinn.